now I think screen is visible to everyone. Visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Hardik, screen visible? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the second method. Write the heading. Ha. Write the second method. Here also the resource one. Resource means the source of preparation is same. Which is the source of preparation? Alkene. Okay, but the method is different. Here method is known under the name hydroboration, and it is an oxidation. That's why it is known under the name by hydroboration oxidation reaction. First, I will explain to you everything I have written in very detailed way so that you will have no understanding problem. First, I will explain. Then you have to copy the same. Then we will go to the next reaction. Okay. Alkene is generally, what is hydroboration? Alkene, any alkene is treated with diborane. What is diborane? Diborane formula is B2H6. So it can be written as BH3 twice, because you know boron has the valency 3. So BH3, that's why it is called boron hydride. It is called borane. Since it is unstable, two molecules are combined. So we get the stable compound diborane. Since there are two BH3 groups are there in this compound, it is known under the name diborane. Understood? It is diborane. Two borane molecules are combined. And it is followed by, first of all, alkene is treated with diborane. Second one, the product obtained is then treated with hydrogen peroxide in presence of NaOH, sodium hydroxide, which leads to the formation of primary alcohol with excellent yield. This is the method of preparation, best method of preparation of primary alcohol, because in this method, yield is maximum. Okay, so this is all about the definition of hydroboration. Now let us take one example. Here I have taken the example of propene. Look at this. CH3, CH double bond CH2. And here again I have split the structure of BH3 as HBH2. Because in the first step, addition reaction taking place, one H is added to one carbon, BH2 is added to the second carbon. So here we got the product and it has the name normal propyl borane. Okay, it is normal propyl. So see the structure, CH3CH, and out of this H and BH2, H is joined with this carbon. See that. And second BH2 part is added to the second carbon by the cleavage of this bond, one pi bond. And second step is one more molecule of propene is added. So look at this. Here, substitution taking place. Look at this. One H again replaced by propyl group. See that. See that one H of BH2. So here the product obtained is called dinormal propyl borane. Still one hydrogen is left along with a boron. The second step is, this one is second step. Third step, one more propene molecule is added, or it is also called a substitution. This hydrogen removed, and which takes the place of that propyl group. Okay, so that is why here it is again propyl, and the name of the product is trinormal propyl borane. Because this compound is considered as the derivative of borane. Three hydrogen atom of borane. See that, three hydrogen atom. Three hydrogen atoms are replaced by propyl group, normal propyl group. And after this, see the reaction. It is treated with hydrogen peroxide in presence of OH minus. And the source of OH minus is NaOH. Look at this, NaOH. So we here we got the last product, propanol, and byproduct is boric acid, BOH thrice. And BOH thrice is also written as H3. So this is all about the process. And which is easy for you, try to write it accordingly. Directly you can write this one. Here you can write 3 propyl group H BH3 twice. And here directly you can write this product. But this is not the proper way of writing the mechanism. That's why I have written illustrated in the proper way. So you can write here one propene is added. See this one propene molecule. Second propene molecule and third propene molecule. So why 3 propene molecules are there? Because BH3, 3 hydrogen atoms are it can be replaced. So that's why here we get the product, and this is the last step, treatment with NaOH and hydrogen peroxide to get a primary alcohol, and boric acid is formed as the byproduct. Okay, so this is all about the reaction, and very important reaction, hydroboration, oxidation. Okay, why is it called oxidation? Very simple. Look at the original substrate, CH3, CH double bond, CH2. There is no oxygen atom along with this compound. But see the last product, one oxygen atom is there. That's why it is also called the oxidation, because oxidation is the process of addition of oxygen. So now I think it is clear to you. So you can write the reaction now. Maybe some of you have written the answer also. Okay, completed.
Then where is NaOH?
Na instead of NaOH. Look at this. OH minus is the representation of NaOH. We are not supposed to put everything along with the equation. What is the use of NaOH? Making the medium alkaline or basic. So what is the symbolic representation of basic medium? OH minus. Last class we have discussed one example where the reaction is acidic medium. So it is symbolically represented as H plus. And similarly in this reaction, this last step associated with a basic medium. So that's why NaOH as the reagent. But in the equation, we need to write only OH minus, more than sufficient. Okay. Why it is water here? Because aqueous NaOH is using. That's why. Okay. So this is all about first. Any other doubt from this topic? You have to learn it like this. Write the equation the way it is there. Okay, then learn it. Clear? Is it clear to all? Deepesh, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And the name of the product, what is that name? Of
name of the product? This one.
Boric acid.
Boric acid, huh? It has two formula, Mary. We can written either as BOH thrice, or we can write it as H3BO3.
No, ma'am, okay. The product both are same with only. Boric acid. 3CH3.
Okay, say. 3 is the balancing, because we have used totally 3 propene. Can you say the name? How many carbon atoms are there? How many carbon? Say 3. No. Okay. OH, 3 carbon containing alkane is
propane.
So is it a monohydric alcohol or dihydric alcohol?
Mono.
Is it mono? Monohydric alcohol, where we have to make the change? For IUPAC naming, where we have to make the change? Last letter E has to be replaced by what?
OL.
Say, E will be replaced by OL. Okay, then say the name.
It can't be propanol.
Say the name of the... propanol. Correct. Propanvanol. Okay. These three is the combined balancing, okay? Because here we are using 1, 2, 3 propene molecule. That's why here we get a 3 propanol molecule. Is it clear to all others? Shifa, are you there? Shifa? Shifa? I don't know. Pranjal?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it written, this one equation written?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let us move to the next reaction. Write the next resource. Write. Second resource is from carbonyl compound. Write the heading, subheading. Preparation of alcohol from carbonyl compound. Okay. Carbonyl. First of all, you try to understand what is carbonyl. Carbonyl means CO compound, the compound which containing CO group. Okay, I'll write it here. Okay, carbonyl means the compounds which contain this group. Okay. Which are carbonyl? C double bond O group. Okay. And this is free valency of carbon and this is also another valency. So those compounds contain carbonyl group are called the carbonyl compound. Can you say some example of carbonyl compounds? Say, here I have already mentioned aldehyde and ketone. Can you say some other example where carbonyl group is there? Say.
Ether
is O only, O functional group. Carboxyl group, correct. Any other compound where CO group is there? We have already seen aldehyde is there, ketone is there, carboxylic acid is there. And fourth one, you can say esters. Esters also contain, because the functional group of ester is RCOOR dash. So COO means what? C double bond O and O. Okay. So this point is very important, carbonyl compound, from carbonyl compound. Now under this heading, we have to discuss the first method by the reduction of aldehydes and ketone, very, very important. Okay. By the reduction of aldehydes and ketone. Here I have mentioned one general equation and one specific example. Before writing all this equation, I will tell you and make you understand one important point. Look at this first case, aldehyde. RCHO means aldehyde. H2 means additional hydrogen. Therefore, the process is called the reduction. So, because classical concept, what is reduction? Addition of hydrogen. Okay, addition of hydrogen. And the catalyst used is palladium. Platinum is not using. Why? What is the reason why platinum is not using in this case? What is the possible reason? Anyone? Why platinum is not used as a catalyst here? What is the reason? What is the logical reason behind?
And they make solution.
Ayush, think again. I have already told you it is a logical answering and it is a correct answer also. Okay, any other answer? Why platinum is not using it? Very good. Anmiri bola hai. Kisne bola tha? Very good. Platinum is highly expensive. So that's why platinum is not using. And instead of platinum, palladium is using here. Look. And look at the compound RCHO. And RCHO is converted into RCH2H. See that there is no change in the number of carbon atom. Look at the change. Where is the change? This is important. CHO group changes into CH2OH. And it is important. This is the functional group of which alcohol? Primary alcohol. Okay, this is the functional group of primary alcohol. So you can write it in words. Aldehydes or reduction resulting a primary alcohol with the same number of carbon atoms. With the same number of carbon atoms. So there is no change in number of carbon atoms. Number of carbon atoms remains same. Okay, so that is the point. Now here I have written a specific example, ethanol. This is ethanol. On reduction, we get ethanol. This is the product obtained. Okay, so this is all about aldehyde. Now come to the next case. What about ketone? Ketone is also a carbonyl compound. When ketone undergo reduction, see that reducing agent has changed. Here we have two choices. Either we can use sodium borohydride or we can use lithium aluminum hydride. Look at the formula. These two we can use. And these two reducing agents are very strong reducing agent compared to hydrogen in presence of palladium. Okay. Why the strong reducing agent is using in this case? Because in this case, carbonyl group, look at this carbonyl group. Either side of carbonyl group, alkyl group is there. So comparatively, CO can't reduce quickly to alcoholic functional group. So in order to reduce this CO group into alcoholic group, strong reducing agents are required. Okay. So reason you know alkyl groups are. Alkyl groups are showing plus effect. So we need to write in detail. So because of this CO, we can't reduce quickly into alcoholic group. And look at the change. CO group converted into CHOH. And CHOH is the functional group of secondary alcohol. So here we can conclude like this. Ketones on reduction with sodium borohydride or lithium aluminum hydride resulting a secondary alcohol. Now look at the change. Only carbonyl group has changed to secondary alcoholic. Rest of the group, there is no change. So that's why this reaction is important. Okay. So write both the equations. Okay. Which one? Ketones. Ketones on reduction. It's strong reducing agents. Strong reducing agents like sodium borohydride, you write the formula NaBH4 or lithium aluminum hydride resulting a secondary alcohol with the same number of carbon atoms. Secondary alcohol with the same number of carbon atoms. Okay. So this is all about the first method from carbonyl compound. And next reaction is this reaction. Again, the method is same, reduction. But here the raw material is different. Either we can use a carboxylic acid or we can use an ester. Both the cases, reducing agents are different. Look at this example. RCOOH undergo reduction followed by hydrolysis, we get a primary alcohol. Okay. Whenever two steps are coming along with the arrow, It means it is a two-step process. Only for simplicity, it is mentioned in the same equation. One is in one above arrow, other is in other in below arrow. So here one means first process is reduction and second is hydrolysis. Generally, we can write a carboxylic acid on reduction followed by hydrolysis resulting a primary alcohol. And look at the reducing agent. Again, in this case also, the reducing agent is strong reducing agent, not weak. And look at the next case, RCOOR dash. What is this? This is an ester. Right. It also contains carbonyl group. So you can write it here. Ester. It is an ester. Ester on reduction. Here, look at this reducing agent. Platinum or palladium. Out of this, which is the most appropriate one? Palladium. Because platinum is expensive, but it can be used as a reducing agent too. So here also we get the product primary alcohol. R and R dash may be same or may be different. So this is the second method. This is all about the second method. So what is the second method of preparation? It is from carbonyl compounds. Three, four different type of carbonyl compounds are there: aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acid, and ester. And in all cases, the method is called a reduction, but the reducing agents are different. First case, aldehydes on reduction, we get primary alcohol. Ketones on reduction, we get secondary alcohol. Carboxylic acid on reduction with reduction followed by hydrolysis resulting a primary alcohol. Ester on reduction, we get primary alcohol. So this is the summary of the reaction. And the most important reaction preparation is third one, and that is from Grignard region. Write the third from Grignard reagent. From this reaction is very, very important. Once you understand the method, then you can write this equation, and this equation can be useful in conversion also, method of preparation also. Okay, so you have to listen very carefully and understand. First of all, what is Grignard reagent? Grignard reagent is alkyl magnesium halide. If you don't know the name, you can write what is Grignard reagent. Alkyl, write it down. Alkyl magnesium halide. It will take time. Alkyl magnesium halide. Okay, alkyl magnesium halide, and alkyl part is there, magnesium is there, and halide is there. So first point is, it is a nucleophilic addition. Nucleophilic addition. Okay. And CO group is the addendum. Addendum means this is the substrate on which this is added. Forms an addition product, which on hydrolysis, second stage hydrolysis, result an alcohol. So first of all, Grignard reagent or nucleophilic addition with a carbonyl group forms an addition product, which on hydrolysis we get an alcohol. Now three equations are very, very important. How is it important? I'll tell you. First of all, we are taking the example methanol. Methanol means formaldehyde. here I have drawn the structure only, so you draw it in the same way. And you write the equation in this way, RmgX. You split RmgX. It is not a solid line, broken line you can use. Okay, here R and Mg, when we compare, tendency to lose electron, which has more tendency, magnesium. Therefore, it gain a partial negative charge, and obviously alkyl group gain a partial negative charge. Look at this, pi bonded electron shifted to more electronegative oxygen atom. As a result, carbon gain a partial positive charge and oxygen gain a partial negative charge. Okay, and look at the addition. This negative part added to positive side, and this whole positive part added to the negative side. Okay, resulting the formation of this product. Clear? And this product on hydrolysis, addition of water, we get primary alcohol. This is the byproduct. MgOHX, and bracket is important. MgOH in small bracket. Okay, I'll repeat. Formaldehyde, this is the substrate. RmG6 the reagent. Here it is broken into two, positive partial charge and positive negative partial negative charge. Pi electron shifted to oxygen. Here it gain a partial negative, carbon gain a partial positive. Then positive part added to negative, and negative part added to positive. So we get the product like this, and we add water. So if you are interested, I will show you one more thing. This portion undergo cleavage. This portion. Okay. What is water? H2O. H2O means we can say that HOH. So out of this HOH, we can add H in this side, and we can add OH in the other side. Okay. Then look at the product. RCH2OH. RCH2OH. And here we get the byproduct MgOHX. This we can say that mechanism of the addition reaction. Okay, mechanism. So this is all about a reaction with the formaldehyde. Look at the other example, all other aldehyde. So which is all other aldehyde? We can start from ethanol. Look at that, mechanism is same. But what about the last product? It is a secondary alcohol. Here we have a primary alcohol. Here we got a secondary alcohol. But the mechanism is same. You can write it in your own mechanism and all. Simple it is. Okay. And similar reaction with the ketone. Look this. Similar reaction. Look at the mechanism. Mechanism is same. And here we get a tertiary. Now, I hope you can understand the significance of this raw material. What is the significance? From Grignard reagent, we can prepare all the three types of alcohol, primary, secondary, tertiary. So, in conclusion, we can write like this. Methanol. Methanol means what? Formaldehyde reacts with Grignard reagent, forms a primary alcohol. All other aldehydes, or you can write aldehydes other than formaldehyde reacts with Grignard reagent, forms a secondary alcohol. Last, all ketones react with Grignard reagent, forms a tertiary alcohol. So this is the only method through which we can prepare all the three type of alcohol. Okay. Understand the mechanism and try to write two or three times today itself and learn it. Very, very important. Again, this can be comes in conversion session. So I will give one work. Two questions I have prepared. So you can write these two questions. Right. This is a homework, and this is also a homework. Okay, try to write these equations. First one, propanone react with the magnesium methyl bromide. Mechanism is same. Second is ethanol reacts with the ethyl magnesium bromide. What is the last product? Okay, this is the homework for you. Homework. Only two equations are there. First, you understand and learn the mechanism. Then you can write this equation. Okay. So this is all about the method of preparation. Three different methods of preparations are there. First one is from alkene. Second one is from which type of compound? Anyone can remember? Second source is what? What is the second source? किसी को याद है? From carbonyl compounds, and third one is from Grignard reagent. So all the methods are important, and I hope you can write these two equations correctly. Okay. So this is all about the preparation. Now leave the space for the answer. Write the next reading. Physical properties of alcohol. Physical properties of alcohol. Okay, so this we will start in the next class and stop sharing now. Okay, now I am back.